Hi everyone, I am very happy to welcome you all to Dr. JJS Virtual Academy of Commerce. In this video, I am going to deliver a lecture on the topic Advantages and Limitations of Major Media Types Available. These are all a few details related to me. After you watch the full video, if you find the video useful to you, give a like to the video. Kindly do subscribe my channel and enable the notification so that you will get the notifications of my new videos on commerce and management subjects. Let's get into the topic. Advantages and limitations of major media types available. We have a list of 7 media types available in front of every marketing organization. Let us get into the details of their advantages and limitations one after other. The first medium available in front of the marketers is television. The advantages of television are good mass marketing coverage, low cost per exposure, combined sight, sound and motion, and the fourth one, it is appealing to the senses. Yes, these are all the wonderful advantages associated with the medium television. The advertisements or marketing communications which are carried over by televisions have good mass marketing coverage. At one click, the company will be able to reach out to a large number of customers. Similarly, cost of reaching every customer through an advertisement is very, very low. And moreover, the specialty of advertisement through television is it combines the sight, sound and motion together and eventually brings out a wonderful effect. Similarly, the last advantage of television is it appeals to the senses of the human beings. Let's get into the limitations of advertisements through television. High absolute cost. Releasing every advertisement through television costs a big money. It requires a huge investment on the part of the marketers. High clutter is the next limitation. Yes, we happen to see quite a high number of television advertisements given by various companies for different products and services. Therefore, every advertisement will face the problem of commercial clutter. The people will get really bored looking at so many advertisements that are released in a television channel during the time of a program. Fleeting exposure is the next limitation. What is the meaning of fleeting exposure? Advertisements released through televisions pass through very quickly. Therefore, the limitation associated with advertisement is of fleeting exposure. It passes through people very quickly. The next limitation is less audience selectivity. Yes, you can't really choose the specific group of audience upon whom you would like to target your product or you would like to target your marketing communication. You can't really restrict the people who should watch a particular program through which you release your advertisement. It goes for the mass public, which could include your target audience as well. The next medium available is nothing but the internet. The advantages of internet are high selectivity. You can specifically select the target audience for your communication through internet. That's a specialty of the medium internet. Low cost. Comparatively, it is associated with low cost because you will be able to reach out to a mass consuming public through internet advertisements. Then immediacy, you can very well plan out your advertisement and release the same through internet without much delay. Therefore, the lead time required is obviously nil with regard to internet. Then interactive capabilities. The advent of modern technology has paved way for interactions between the marketing communicators and the people who view the communication in the form of advertisements released on internets. Limitations of the medium internet. Relatively low impact. Comparing the advertisements through television or newspaper and other media, this particular medium is relatively having low impact. The next one is about the audience control exposure. The audience can very well have control over watching your advertisement or skipping your advertisement. And that's what about the limitations of internet. Then the next medium available is newspapers. It has got the flexibility. Since the newspaper is available for the whole day in the hands of the readers, they can very well go through the advertisement when time permits for them in the day. Then timeliness, similarly the lead time required for releasing an advertisement through the medium newspaper might be a day or less than that. You can very well release the advertisement within a short span of time. The next advantage is what? Good local market coverage. Reaching out to the consumers in a particular locality will be really effective if the advertisements are released through newspapers. Broad acceptability. Definitely, newspapers enable the marketers to have broad acceptability for their marketing communication in the form of advertisements through newspapers. Then, traditionally, newspapers have been accepted as a good source of communication, or the newspapers have built trust in the minds of the readers. Therefore, the message released through newspapers in the form of advertisements will have high believability among the readers. Regarding limitations for newspapers, short life. Obviously, the life of a newspaper is a day. Then poor reproduction quality. The same advertisements cannot be reproduced every day in the newspaper because it will be boring for the readers. Then small pass-along audience. There are many readers of newspapers. They pass through the pages of advertisements in the newspapers. This is a greater disadvantage associated with the newspaper. The next medium available is nothing but direct mail. It has got the advantages of high audience selectivity. You can select the customers with whom you would like to communicate through advertisements is made possible if you choose direct mail as the medium of your advertisement. The next one, it is flexible. They can very well read the mail or the communication which you send to the target customers in the form of emails according to their convenience. Then the next one is about no ad competition within the same medium. Since your email is more customized and men are sent for a selected group of audience, you don't find any sort of competition with other companies with regard to communicating with the target audience. The last advantage of direct mail is it allows personalization. You can very well personalize your marketing communication if it is moved through direct mail towards the target customers. Regarding limitations of direct mail, relatively high cost per exposure. You can't really reach out to or effectively reach out to every customer through a single mail. You have to continuously monitor and keep sending the messages. Then only it would be possible on your part to reach out to the target customers effectively. Therefore, it also involves a bit higher cost. Then junk mail image. What is a junk mail image? The message we send to our target customers through email will get into the lot of junk mails in the email box of the readers. This will really create a kind of a bad image or inappropriate image for the company which volunteers to send messages through emails to the target customers. And the next medium available is magazine. Advantages of magazines: high geographic and demographic selectivity within the area the magazine is circulated. Credibility and prestige. The credibility and prestige of the magazine could also be enjoyed by the messages, the marketing communications which are published through such magazines. High quality reproduction. Now, through the advancements in the printing technology, companies can come out with very colorful and very attractive kind of advertisements or marketing communication if they are carried over through magazines. Then long life and good pass along readership. Comparing newspaper, magazines have got long life. Might be a week or more than a week or a month or 6 months, things like that. Sometimes if they are stored properly in libraries and places like, you can find the lifespan of the magazines would be comparatively longer. And there is a good pass along readership for the marketing communications which are passed through magazines. Then regarding limitations for magazines, long ad purchase lead time. To release an advertisement in a magazine, definitely the marketers have to negotiate with the publishers of the magazine well in advance. They need to wait for might be a week time or a month time or more than that. It depends upon the popularity and familiarity of the magazines. So there is definitely a longer lead time to purchase a space for your advertisement in magazines. It involves high cost. Every word and every line what you are going to communicate through the magazine advertisement is costing very high. No guarantee of position. And similarly, you don't find a situation where a specific space in the magazine could be allotted to you all the time. It depends upon the availability of the space your advertisements will be released. So that's the limitation of magazines. Regarding the next medium available, it is radio. The advantages of radio: good local acceptance. People who listen to radio, a particular radio station in a locality, they listen to your advertisements released through radio. So there is a good local acceptance for your marketing communication released through selective radio stations and programs. High geographic and demographic selectivity. If you properly select the radio station and its program, obviously you will be enabled to select the specific group of target consumers with whom you would like to communicate through radio advertisements. Then comparing other form of advertisements, radio advertisements are associated with low cost. Regarding limitations of radio, audio only. Radio advertisements will have only the audio communication. You don't find provision for the video communication as well. Then fleeting exposure. When the radio advertisements are released, people should listen to it. If people miss that advertisement, definitely radio advertisements like television advertisements pass through very quickly. So that's a limitation of radio advertisement. Low attention. That means the half heard medium. Since it doesn't have provision for visual effect in the advertisements, we can very well gain only low attention of the listeners of radio programs. Then the next one is about fragmented audience. You can't specifically choose a program meant for your target audience. The programs which are listened by your target audience will also be listened by others. And similarly, there could be a variety of programs, radio programs, which would be watched by or listened by your target audience. Therefore, in every program of a radio, you find it consists of fragmented audiences. The last medium available for marketing communication is outdoor. The advantages are, it is highly flexible. Similarly, it has got high repeat exposure associated with low cost, then low message competition, and finally, good positional selectivity. Let me explain these points. The outdoor hoardings or signboards, they are really flexible in communicating with the target audience. If the target audience do not watch your hoarding or your marketing communication released through hoardings or signboards once, they can very well watch it again when they pass through the same hoarding. Similarly, high repeat exposure. When you pass through a particular hoarding, every time you get the opportunity to get exposed to the same marketing communication of a company. Low cost, comparing other medium of advertisement, you can find this particular medium is associated with low cost. Then low message competition. You don't find so many hoardings are situated or established in a particular place. There are a couple of hoardings which will carry the messages of a few companies for the promotion of their products and services. Therefore, we can definitely say it is associated with low message competition. And finally, good positional selectivity. You get a greater chance to select a proper place where you can keep the hoarding of your advertisement or signboard of your advertisement in order to reach out to the target consumers. It is based on the places your target consumers pass through. You can very well place the hoarding accordingly. Regarding limitations of the medium outdoor, little audience selectivity and creative limitations. Though you are able to locate the place which is passed through by your target audience very often, getting a place, getting a space to keep your hoarding which will carry your marketing communication is a cumbersome task. And therefore, you will be landed with the situation of having little audience selectivity. And similarly, hoarding doesn't have high creativity. This is a biggest limitation of the medium which is named to be outdoor. I hope I have done my lecture up to a level of satisfaction. If you really like this video, give a like to the video. Thanks for watching this video. I'll meet you in another video. Bye for now, everyone.